the speaker, because this person will, I've never heard her say no. She just says, I'll just do what you want me to do. And is the pastor in the house? Where is he? Okay, there. I was going to ask him to come down. Because, you know, thank you, Pastor, for coming. Okay, amen. Praise God, praise God. Well, as I said, the song is so appropriate because our speaker is one who will just do whatever you ask her to do. And actually, you don't even have to ask her. When she sees a need, whatever she sees that her hands could do, she will do that. And we gave her such a short notice and asked if she would speak today. And it wasn't like, oh, well, I need a month, you know, I need a lot more time. She just willingly said yes. And I've known our speaker for a number of years. And I think she's just a beautiful person with a lovely personality. She is a very intelligent person, but yet at the same time, she can relate to the common person. She has a common touch, a very common touch. If you really didn't know me, she carries herself well, and as I said, she can relate to anyone. Our speaker this morning is our own very own Deborah Williams. Let me give you a little bio on her. She has a Bachelor of Arts degree in Sociology, a Master's in Behavior Science. That's where she learned. Well, I think it's an eight. Where she learned how to just relate to people. And for 32 years, she has worked as a human resources consultant. And I know within that area that there's been a lot of refinement, there's been a lot of tests and challenges, and she has surmounted that. Sister Deborah has been married to our own Brother Beauty for 37 years. She is the mother of two lovely, beautiful young ladies, Tiffany and Angela. Ladies and gentlemen, Northside, help me to welcome our speaker, Sister Deborah Williams. She's going to come to us with words of wisdom. And I don't know of anyone who, I mean, she's going to come. Praise God. Isn't this beautiful?
Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Amen.
This morning, I'm going to try to lift this mic up on top of my hands. So I'm going to try to keep it in the right place. People over there try to hook me up to the other thing, but I realize I don't have anything to hook up to. So I'm glad it's just family this morning. I thank God for the opportunity to stand before you today. I prepared notes, but as everyone got up, I went, mine's in the right place. And even when I came in from Sunday school, Sister Hill said, my prayers were answered. I thought I was glad to see your daughters come in. And we'd already talked about it. And so they were going to sing in the choir, as they do at their church, and then tip out and tip over. But they changed their minds. And so I was encouraged this morning. And as Sister Hill was announcing, my daughter, my baby said, she out of hate. So they're here to help me, keep me grounded. And again, I thank God for this opportunity today. I too, like Sister Hill, most recently lost my mother. So, I probably couldn't have talked about this last year this time, but it's been about a year and a half. And she was just very, very special. As you young mothers get older or as you mature and work with your children, that's when you learn the value of what you have. Yes. And so, for a long time, and when I left home, I was like, I'm never going back. That is the hardest woman I've ever seen. But she was a woman of God, and she was, you know, what we probably call today old school. Sometimes I hear pastors talk about some of those things we used to do in the church, and you know, we came through in a time when when Afro first came out, you wasn't supposed to do that. And then, you know, then you didn't do wigs, and then you didn't wear earrings and the quads, and then you dressed had to be this way, and, you know. So we managed to get through that with her, and she trained us up in the way that she thought that we should go. And as I went away saying, I'm never coming back, the word is true and the word is right.
Yes.
I did come back. I didn't depart. Those things went with me, and while I was doing what I thought I could do, that I was grown enough to do, and the things that she didn't give me an opportunity to experience, and I thought I had missed something, those things resonated in my mind. And there were times when I thought, ooh, you know, one time I had an invitation to do something that I knew full well was wrong, and the person giving me that invitation, he said, so what's your mom gonna do? Pull you through the phone, and I was like, what? But it was in my mind that it was wrong. So I thank God for her today. And right before, in the last 16 years or so, my grandmother lived with her. And so she was 101. So I had the privilege for the last 16 or 17 years prior to her death that I had both of them. And my grandmother was the epitome of Church of God in Christ, and I knew we had one in the house. And so I had that experience, and my children, and I praise God for them. My mother passed in Thanksgiving of 2009, and my grandmother, 101, passed in December of 2009. So, you know, it was a big gap, it was a big loss, but I praise God that I had the experience, and that he helped me through that. And just right here at Northside, there were several in the house. I saw her wave a hand. You know, she had an experience. And so right there in the circle, seems like all of us were having, it's just that season in our lives. And you know that we had losses and we were able to encourage each other through that. I hope that the word that I have in my heart to share today, I can express it the way I feel it. Again, happy Mother's Day to everyone. You know, mothers aren't just those that gave birth to someone. That's the direction I wanted to go this morning. We've been having teachings, Sister Hill, on the Sunday that we dedicated the babies a couple of Sundays ago, gave us much words of wisdom and how to encourage the young mothers and fathers today. It's Mother's Day. I'm like, Sister Jessica, let me talk about y'all and you. But she gave us encouragement on how to address those challenging things that are coming. She knows, been there, done that, and between the two of us, you know, and some of us others that are seasoned, Mother Elam, and some of those that are grown, Sister Irene, that, you know, could call names. But those that have reared their children, we know that it's not always easy. And we learned, we can tell you now, because we probably made some of those mistakes. And, you know, to recognize that each one of the children are so individually different. There's not a cookie cutter, and they're not going to all be different. Jessica talked about Bradley, and he's got a quiet spirit. But Miss Chelsea, I watch her. And she has a whole nother different spirit. And so we have to be careful to rear our children and to instruct them as different individuals, even little. They come with so many intricacies, and we want to be careful about that. But even Sister Hill, that a couple Sundays ago, started with that teaching. I'm just trying to make a reference point. And Pastor has been teaching for the last 4 months or so, the end times, that's become relevant for us. We are living in the end times. We see it. It's the latest Osama bin Laden. We don't even know what's coming after all of that, as some people are asleep and not paying attention to the signs. Pastor has been trying to get our attention about the signs of the times. And then It's getting spring. The weather's getting more pleasant. Pastor Williams is back on his evangelism press. He's trying to get us interested in the need to evangelize. And so today, when I think of mothers, or as it came to me, that there's so many other types of mothers. And some of us have already reared them, and we have some that are foster mothers. There are stepmothers. There are mothers in the Lord, and I have the privilege of even being a stepmother, and I have been a mother to, this child came and visited, and we fed him. and he never went away. I heard my phone go off, and he was leaving me a message, and you know, he's not with us today, but God blessed him, and he was in a bad situation, and you know, you just know when it's the thing to do. And I thought later, well, just a few times of him being home and spending the night, and I thought, I'm just kidding, we're asking him for something. I don't know what kind of issues he's got. But the Lord gave him to us, and we have been taking care of him. He's been successful. He's now a father of three children of his own. But he keeps up with us, and I thank God for that. I thank God for my stepson and his beautiful wife and children. But there are all kinds of mothers. There's mothers beside those that have given birth to a child. And that's where I was directed this morning. And then there's those that are like a mother to us. I watched Irene and I watched Sister Khalilah come in. And I know she's mothering that. I know she's mothering you.
Yes.
She's going, yes. Yes. And so there's that relationship. And you know, I have to boast. My children, you know, I'm proud of them. They completed college, and you know, the right person hasn't found them yet, so they're still with us. And in their church, I see their mother, and now we have a whole other generation coming through the house. But they are teaching them and sharing with them the things that they've learned from me and their grandmother and their great grandmother. And I thank God for that this morning. Webster defines mothering. Again, as I said, it's not just giving birth to someone. It defines mothering as looking after. Someone who takes care of. Someone who watches over. Someone who tends to. Provides for. Nurses. Nurtures. And or supports. When you do some all these things in some form or fashion, you don't always have to be the one that's, you know, the natural mother that someone that you have those responsibilities. That it's a high calling, but mothering is some of all those things. And I know we can all probably encounter or think of people that we've encountered that had a concern for us, that had a special interest in us, you know, as we came along. And then even those that are younger are just about to get into their own responsibilities. You know, I see the students, they come in and deal with our children, our younger children. And that is where my heart is. I love children's church. I keep saying I'm out of that season. I just don't want to do that, but I cannot not do take care of the responsibility that God has given me. And I think all of us have that responsibility in some form or fashion. Sister Jessica comes in and she's ministering to the children. She was ministering to here, through the children's church here. So it's a high calling, and we have a responsibility. And today, with the lessons that we're getting about the end time and the need to evangelize. And evangelism is just, by definition, to seek people and draw them.